Casey, hit that track.
It can't be bargained with. It can't be reasoned with. It doesn't feel pity or remorse or fear. And it absolutely will not stop. Ever.
I am shocked and appalled.
I am shocked and chagrined, mortified and stupefied.
So you're trying to play GM and you started a mod. So I go to my boy Money Martin, oh, we pop in the truck. We tell the mother, gonna shock your mock, 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 gonna shock your mock.
All right, so yesterday wasn't a good look. Wasn't a look for Shock Your Mock, wasn't a good look for scouts, wasn't a good look for anybody.
Wasn't a good look for knowing your name.
Wasn't a look for knowing the name. It wasn't a good look overall. And seeing how, you know, I'm bringing up the ultimate energy because we got Shock Your Mock, and hopefully we go back-to-back slam poetry. Yeah, I have to get my mind right. I have to get my energy right, and we're ready to roll. Today's Shock Your Mock is featured, and this guy reached out to me personally and said this is his third Shock Your Mock year in a row. So he
got a streak.
So he went for the fabled turkey, right? I'm not sure if anybody else can say that they have the fabled turkey right now on Action Sports Jax on ESPN 690. And this mock is coming from Josh the Fat Man, all right? I'm not sure if it's a play on words. I'm not sure if he's really fat. Doesn't really matter.
Space eater.
He could be a space eater. You know, as some scouts would say, maybe he's got the bubble. I have no idea, right? All I know from Josh the Fat Man, he's a loyal listener, number one. But number two, if you're watching the stream, he's got a very interesting profile picture. I'm not sure what that character is. Looks like a cross between Gizmo from Gremlins and then like Lilo and Stitch. And when I say Lilo and Stitch, I mean, I think Stitch because he was the alien guy,
Stitch,
right?
Stitch was the alien, yes.
I saw it once, dude. You know what I'm saying?
It's also a good representation of that mean bear in Toy Story 3 if it was this color.
Yes, or the mean bear from Toy Story 3. I'm sure we can all relate to that one as well.
Exactly.
Actually, I got that better than Lilo and Stitch. So, okay, let's get into it. Shock Your Mock on a Friday. Let's go. Pick number one, we got Aiden Hutchinson out of Michigan, right? I'll say it again till the cows come home. Very interesting picture that he chose to use for PFF, right? He's got the one eye black streak coming down his eye. Don't know if I'm scared. Don't know if we should make fun of him. But if he's a Jacksonville Jaguar with the first overall pick, we're going to embrace it, Brent, okay? And we're going to embrace it together. You know how I feel about it. I think it's a safe pick. You do what you got to do. Josh the Fat Man, I'm not mad at pick number one. Now we get a little trade happy, okay? We're starting to trade now with the second pick. So Josh chose to trade pick 33 and pick 198 for pick 25.
Oh, I like it.
Do I dare say I'm not mad at this?
I love it.
Do I dare say that I'm not mad at this? Right? Because what do we always talk about? If you have to get your guy to trade up, then go ahead and get your guy to trade up. Trent Baalke, I hope you're listening. So with pick number 25, we're going Treylon Burks, a guy we haven't talked about a lot in terms of Shock Your Mock, but I like this dude a lot. 6'2", 225, ran a 4.55 40-yard dash at the combine. Now, keep in mind, that number, the 4.55, scouts expected him to run in the 4.4 range. So there was a little disappointment there in terms of speed. All I know is that Devontae Adams probably runs a 4.5. DeAndre Hopkins probably runs a 4.5. We can get away, Brent, with a 4.5. I don't need Treylon Burks to run a 4.4. I'm a believer. Lance Zierlein had an interesting player comparison for Treylon Burks. He said he's A.J. Brown with a little more wiggle.
Ooh.
So I'm not sure if he's a better dancer than A.J. Brown. I'm not sure if he's got more fluid hips than A.J. Brown. But we talk about A.J. Brown being, I think he's one of the premier receivers in the league. And now you give him a wiggle? How can you not like that?
I do. That means physical, right? Physical and wiggle and shiftiness. I like that.
Yeah, for sure. You know, he did come in at 6'2 at the combine. I think there might have been someone trying out to get him. I'm not sure if there was like an SEC guy. I don't know what was going on, but he looks like he's 6'7. Okay, he looks like Shaquille O'Neal in shoulder pads. Like, this guy looks ginormous. He looks a lot bigger than 6'2 to me. I'd put him at 6'4, but he weighed in 6'2. It is what it is. When he played Alabama, you know, Alabama, pretty good team, a well-respected team. He had 8 catches, 179 yards, and two TIDs, right? And I say TIDs. Now, if you're listening, TIDs means touchdown. So first time listening to Shock Your Mock, TIDs means touchdown. Not the other thing that what you probably thought you heard. Not talking about Dolly Parton. Talking about touchdowns. And he had two of them against Alabama. So Treylon Burks is a guy
can
that I like.
Say that?
What can I say that?
I guess you can't. Do it.
Just said it. So Treylon Burks, pick number 25, I like a lot. Let's keep on going. Now, pick number 65 got traded away along with pick 222, and we moved up to pick number 60. It's a lot to follow along, especially if you're listening. I know what it is, but you know what? This isn't a bad trade either. Why? Because you're trying to get your guys. Now here, maybe would want to see a linebacker, right? Maybe want to see an offensive lineman of some sort. He went with Trey McBride, all right? Trey McBride, tight end out of Colorado State at pick number 60 via the trade. If you read the comparison to Trey McBride, it reminds you a lot of what TJ Hockenson was coming out of college, right? This is a dual tight end. And by dual tight end, I mean he loves to run block just as much as he loves catching touchdowns. So you like a guy who can kind of do both, and Trey McBride is definitely that guy. You guys ready for these numbers? Casey, ready for these numbers? Brent, ready for these numbers? Get a button ready. His last year, 90 catches, over 1,000 yards receiving, and take a guess how many touchdowns this guy had.
14.
Casey?
11.
One. He had one touchdown. So now all of a sudden, now I'm a little worried, right? I kind of got
terrible.
You guys. Yeah, I kind of had you guys, you know, feeling excited, and
yeah,
you should
be geeked up.
90 catches, 1,000 yards, one touchdown. So I'm not sure if there's like a situation where maybe the quarterback didn't know he was actually left-handed, not right-handed, and they couldn't give Trey McBride the ball for touchdowns. I don't know what happened there. I like the catches. I like the 1,000 yards, but the one touchdown really scares me, and it really scares me for a guy you're taking in the second round. I'm not sure what happened in Colorado State. I didn't watch a lot of Colorado State film, and as far as the combine's concerned, he didn't take part in any of the drills at the combine. So if anybody in Colorado or Colorado State was watching PBS and saw Trey McBride's pro day, please feel free to call us, let us know how he did, because obviously ESPN isn't showing a Colorado State pro day. So I'm not sure what the numbers look like. I know he's intriguing. He's got those TJ Hockenson comparisons, but the lack of productivity in terms of the touchdown department, woo, it scares me.
Yeah, that's scary.
All right, let's go on to pick number 70 now. Now we're back on
track. I will say this. Well, I'll jump in and say at least he's going after weapons for Trevor.
Oh, yeah, this is definitely the make Trevor Lawrence happy draft right now, yeah.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah. And Treylon Burks, one other note on him, he was picking up a ton of steam during the season, but it feels like after the season, so many others now are passing him by. You know, it's weird.
Yeah. He's one of those guys that you can't forget about it, because we always get so infatuated with speed, and I understand that. It's a fast game, and Burks probably doesn't have, you know, the breakaway speed.
Yeah.
But he's a big-bodied receiver, man, and you got to take him seriously as well.
All right. By the way, we do have a comment during Shock Your Mock. I'm a CSU grad guy at 1,000 yards while lining up as an inline blocker on like 80% of the snaps. But we're the touchdown CSU grad.
We got scoring points or not?
Come on, Rams.
We got scoring points or not? All right, let's go to pick number 70 now. Channing Tindall, all right, out of Georgia. You like those Georgia Bulldogs in this mock draft that everyone
like
seems to
app.
Be liking? Sounds like a what?
An app.
Sounds like Channing Tindall? Tindall. I'll give it to you. So pick number 70, Channing Tindall, I'm sorry. Linebacker. See, now you're messing me up, man. Good player. Now get this. Not a peer one gapper. But not a peer two gapper either. Casey, hit the button. What are these scouts talking about?
How many times do we have to teach you this lesson, old man?
I love the young people.
I'm so sick and tired of the olds running the NFL in terms of how they feel about breaking down, you know, players in terms of the scouting department. What is that supposed to mean? He's a peer one gapper, but no, I'm sorry. He's not a peer one gapper, but he's not a peer two gapper. Is there a three gap that I'm not seeing? Is there a four gapper that I'm not talking about? Either you're a one-gapper or you're a two-gapper. Pick one. Pick a lane, scouts. I can't work with this with Channing Tindall, okay? You can't say he's not good at one-gapping, and he's not really good at two-gapping, so he's not good then, okay? I guess he's just not good,
just
all right?
Good.
What are we talking about here?
He's a Georgia Bulldog. He's good.
Yeah, but long story short with this guy, so there is a lot of intrigue with him. Teams are skeptical, though, because he did play with such a great defense, and they're wondering at the next level when he doesn't have the Jordan Davis, when he doesn't have the N'Kobe Deans, when he doesn't have the Devontae Wyatts, when he doesn't have the Michael Carter. I think Michael Carter, right? Michael Carter? No. Jalen Carter. That's off the top of the dome, Brent. I'm trying to remember Georgia Bulldogs. Jalen Carter.
Michael Carter was a UNC guy. I think.
Yeah, there you go. Thank you very much. One could question how well is he going to do at the next level without those guys around him. I still think it's an okay pick. He can definitely come in right away and compete for a starting spot. So I'm not as mad at this pick as I am with the scouts who want to talk all the smack about him and say, well, he's not really a one-gap or a two-gap. Well, then what is he, sir? Come on, let's keep it real here. Pick number 106, we're going to Tennessee, Rocky Top. Worst song in all of college football, but it is what it is. Matthew Butler. Now, Matthew Butler comes in at 6'4", 297 pounds, playing defensive tackle / defensive line. Would probably be suited for a one gapping scheme because he is a little undersized, right? Like, think of Calais Campbell, but obviously more on the skinnier side. He plays bigger than what he really is, which helps out a lot. But I just think if this defense is going to be playing a 3-4 scheme, I'm not sure if Matthew Butler, is going to be the guy that's going to fill that role. He is a decent pass rusher. You can have him in on sub packages. He ran a 5-flat, you know, defensive tackle. It is what it is. But the cool thing about him, and when I say he ran a 5-flat, he literally ran a 5.00 in the combine. Might be the first time ever. 5.00. I don't know why that's such a big deal to me, but I just like that odd number. You know,
stop the cap.
Exactly. I like that, just that odd number with that five and then just two zeros after. I don't know. It's just, it's aesthetically pleasing to me. Very feng shui. So he could be a very feng shui player for this defense. But like I echoed, he's a little undersized. How will he look in a 3-4 defense? I'm not sure if he's going to be there. All right, let's go to Miami. I don't mean the Miami Hurricanes. I mean the Miami Hawks. Cardinal? What is Miami again in Ohio?
The Red Hawks.
Yeah. I mean, come on, you know, it's the Red Hawks. All right, so we got Sterling Weatherford, safety, out of Miami of Ohio. Prototypical special teams kind of guy, high-effort kind of guy. Couldn't really find a lot about this dude. A little on the undersized part, but could be on sub-packages. So could play safety, could play nickel corner. This is more of the depth pick right now. Won't come in for a starting spot right away, but it's a guy that you want on your team because he's a good character dude and eventually could work his way into like a nickel or a safety spot, but nothing a guy that's going to knock your socks off day one.
All right.
Pick number
one. I want my socks knocked off and shock your mind.
Oh, you want your socks knocked off? Well, let's talk about endorsements at pick 180. Center, Luke Wattenberg. If you don't get Luke Wattenberg a Whataburger endorsement, then something's up. Hey, Luke, fire agent right now. Go and hire me. I'll get you that by tomorrow. So Luke Wattenberg, he's a center but can also play guard. Has a lot of starting experience. Played 4 years at Washington. Probably more of a center than he's going to be a guard, which, hey, the Jaguars kind of need. So he's a guy that can actually come in and maybe compete for a starting spot. His biggest, like, pro of, like, what scouts are saying, and once again, this is the olds talking, so Casey, go and get that button ready. His biggest, like, takeaway from watching film is that he has a functional gallop.
How many times do we have to teach you this lesson, old man?
I love the young people.
Are we watching football? Are we watching the Churchill Downs? What do you mean he's got a functional gallop? What does that mean? He's a center. He's got to go 3 or 4 yards at the most. He never has to gallop. Why is he galloping? And what made you think it was functional? Do you mean it's normal? Do you mean the guy can run and he's not hampered? He doesn't have a limp? Hey, olds, you got to get out of the league in the scouting department. I can't handle many more of these shocking. Like, it's slowly starting to turn into Shock Your Mock, from Shock Your Mock to me going on a personal vendetta against every NFL scout out there. And I don't like the road that I'm traveling down, but so be it. I will travel down it by myself if I have to. Call me Mad Max. Let's move on. Pick 188. We're going Hassan Haskins out of Michigan. You know, this is a pick at 188 I'm not mad about, right? He's kind of on the outside looking in. People are saying in terms of him making a roster, it could be up in the air. But this team maybe does need a third down back. Maybe they do need a third or fourth string running back. He can fill that role. The second string running back off the get-go is a little sketchy, in my opinion. You know, people are questioning his vision a little bit, his ability to hit the hole. But long story short, There is some intrigue. There is some speed. There is some agility. He's a guy that you bring in, see what he can do, and hopefully get the best out of him. Rounding out this list, we got pick 197, Josh Rivas coming out of Kansas State, guard. And then finishing up the list, we got round seven, pick 235, Trey Sterling, safety out of Oklahoma State. Depth guys right here. Trey Sterling will be more likely a special teams guy trying to make the roster with Josh Rivas as well.
Well, what's our overall takeaway? I feel like this has a lot of defensive players. Are they going this heavy on the defensive side? I mean, I guess they can mix it up this year. A lot of times teams will do this. They'll alternate how they do it. They'll go heavy in free agency on one side of the ball, and then they'll go heavy in the draft on the other side of the ball. And that's kind of a little bit of a tale as old as time in NFL personnel.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like the Jags want a little of both in free agency, so does that open them up to do a little bit of both, maybe like this draft, this shock your mock right here?
No, so like as far as this draft is concerned here from Josh the Fat Man, he did address a lot of needs. Now, when he addressed the needs, like a guy like Matthew Butler, you know, I think interior defensive line is still a need that you got to take seriously, and I'm not sure if Matthew Butler is going to fit in the system that Caldwell is going to run, right? So you address the need, but did you get the right guy to address said need? You know, Trey McBride is definitely an intriguing prospect. A small school guy could turn into something special at pick 60, but there you could have maybe taken a different linebacker, right? Maybe a more valued linebacker. So overall, like, it's not the worst mock draft that I've seen, but in terms of, you know, the bang for your buck, I like the trades. I like the picks right up front. But then as we went down the list a little bit, we started to fall off. So I'm not saying it's a great mock draft. I'm not saying it's a bad mock draft. I'm just saying it's kind of like Justin Bieber's latest album. There's some hits. There's some, I don't know about that one. But overall, I think exclusively, people are going to like it.
Okay, well, so really, this shock your mock, Josh the Fat Man, saved a little bit by your annoyance with the scouts.
Yeah, I mean, listen, Josh, I have no personal vendetta against you. This is more of a war right now with the scouts. And as we break more and more players down, the more and more I start getting upset. To the point where it's the day before the draft, we do the last shock your mock. I may come untethered. I may come unraveled. There is no telling what I'm capable of. I might go to Indianapolis next year myself and start just, I don't know, slapping books out of scouts' hands if I have to. There's no telling what I'm capable of, Brent.
We should do a whole segment where we have to use all this terminology or just come up with our own.
I like that.
Yeah, we might have to do that. We'll plan on it.